Well, I guess this is needs a bit of a spoiler alert in case you didn't watch it. So last night, the Jeopardy Masters semifinal ends in a tie to advance to the finals. What are the odds of that? It came down to Mattea Roach and Andrew He in a tie to advance. In the United States, we despise ties. Like my entire life, if something ended in a tie, they always said the tie game is like kissing your sister, which goes back to this Navy football coach in 1953 after a 0-0 tie with Duke, Eddie Ertelatz. I had no idea who originally came up with that saying. And thanks to my Jamaican friend Junior, who comes over and we watch English Premier League soccer. I get it. Draws are actually useful. You get the points. But here in the United States growing up, a tie is just terrible, right? And so when Mattea and Andrew ended up in a tie to advance, it was very unsatisfying to me. The question today is, what are the odds of that happening? And before I get into the Excel, for those of you who are not Excel people, let's just come out and take a look at the possibilities. So there's 1,296 possible scenarios of how the points could add up after the games. And the chance of any tie happening is 18.5%. So better than 1 in 6, almost 1 in 5 chance that we were going to have a tie. And it could have been worse. There's, 2% of the time there would have been a 3-way tie, and 2% of the time there would have been a 4-way tie. Now, the reminder of the tiebreakers, it's number of wins. And in this case, in the semifinals, neither had a win. And then it came down to this: total correct responses in the semifinals, including Final Jeopardy. And Mattea won with 50 correct answers, and Andrew only had 45, which makes you go back to the beginning of the episode where they showed that montage of Mattea quickly answering, 5, 6 questions in a row. That seemed really unusual to me at the time, but thinking about it, that makes a lot of sense that they were foreshadowing that it was that run in her earlier semifinal game that is going to make the difference in the tiebreaker. If it was still tied after that, then it's cumulative scores excluding Daily Double and Final Jeopardy wagers, and then cumulative scores excluding Final Jeopardy wagers. So there you are. For those of you who just want to know, what are the chances of a tie happening with the 9-3-2-2 points there? It was almost a 20% chance that we were going to have to see a tiebreaker. Hey, for those of you who are here for the Jeopardy answer, thanks for watching. Please click like down below. Remember the channel. If you ever have an Excel question, come on back. We will be happy to answer that for you. For all my regular Excel viewers, let's take a look at the Excel behind this model for it to go down. All right, so for my Excel friends, let's take a look at this great model that figured it out. It's reminiscent of back in the World Cup where I was trying to figure out the possible things for the group stage. We have 4 players and only 3 compete at a time, so how can you do every possible combination of those? The combined function equals COMBIN of 4 taken 3 at a time. There are 4 possibilities. And I was actually trying to get my head wrapped around how you would ever build that, but it's really just simple. In each of the games, one of the people is missing. So the first time, player A is missing, then B, then C, then D. Going back and looking at the tape, that would have been A is Mattea Roach, B is Matt Modio, C is Andrew He, and D is James Holzhauer. But as I built this, I didn't use anyone's names. I just had player A, B, C, and D. And then in any one game, the winner gets 3 points, the second place person gets 1 point, and the third place person gets 0 points. So what are the possibilities? There's 6 ways that any game could happen. So player 1 wins, player 2 is in second, player 1 wins, player 3 is in second, and so on. So we have 4 games and 6 possible scenarios. So that's you basically do a full outer join here of which game and which scenario. This little key field here, I'm going to use that later in my XLOOKUP. So there's not really a game 11. It's just game 1 concatenated with a 1. I should have put a dash in between, but I didn't even know I was going to make a video. I was just doing this for my own interest this morning. All right, so coming back here, there's 4 games, 6 scenarios. So we take 6 raised to the 4th power. There's 1,296 possible ways. The sequence function of 1,296, and then this is just basically like a binary count up, except it's not binary. It's kind of base 6, but it's not really base 6 because we have the numbers 1 to 6 instead of 0 to 5. But you get it here. We have the numbers 1 to 6 repeating 1 to 6, 1 to 6, 1 to 6. And then out here, 6-1, 6-2, 6-3s, and so on. Nice little formula here just to check to see if the number To the right of me is a 1. The number right and above is a 6. And then advancing this, unless it was already a 6, then resetting it back to 1. And that formula just gets copied to the left. And we get all of our possible outcomes for the 1,296 different ways that this could go down. All right, and then a technique here in columns A, B through A, G. Let's just solve it for one possible outcome. So you know, put an outcome in here. I just randomly chose 777. Do an index to get those four outcomes. So if we come down here, let's just do one that we can see on the screen. So if we put in a 10 here, you'll see that we get 1124, 1124. So that means in game one, I had to go look up key field game 1-1, game 2-1, game 3-2, game 4-4. And then looking up that key field, which player was it? So in this case, game 1-1 would be player B. And how many points did they get? They would have gotten 3 points, right? And copy that across and down. So we have for the four games going across, for the three players, which player and how many points did they score? Now I had to get all this back into one little table. Lucky for me that we now have the HSTACK function. So I HSTACK the players and then did a transpose. So you see BAAA right there, and then CCBB, CCBB, and then same thing, get the points, just get everything back together. You know, the goal for this solving strategy is just to have one input cell and as many fields as you need in as ugly a manner as makes sense to you to come down to one final outcome. And that outcome here is player A ended with 6, player B ended with 6, player C ended with 3, and player D ended with 1. So once we have this model, and it'd be interesting just to know how many formulas there actually are in this model. So if we go to special and select just the formulas, click OK, 19 formulas to get to just the answer for this one of the 1,296 outcomes. But then the absolute beautiful thing about Excel is back here on the Data tab under What If Analysis, the Data Table. This is an amazing tool. So we have a model that's set up to solve one scenario. Put a list of all 1,296 scenarios down the left-hand side. Little formulas that point to our outcomes here, so A, B, C, D in total, and then select that whole range. And then with this whole thing selected, the scenario numbers down the left-hand side, the five output cells across the top, What If Analysis, Data Table, and we say that our column input cell is right there. That takes each of these 1,296 numbers one at a time and plugs them into the outcome and records the output cells. All right, then, once we have the, so in this scenario one, it was someone had 9 points, 5 points, 2 points, 0 points. Sort those high to low. I remember that when Microsoft came out with the sort function, they were very proud of the fact that they had this sort by column at the end, something that Google Sheets didn't have at the time, and it came out handy in this case. Had it not been there, I would have just had to use the large function. So this orders the people high to low, concatenates them together. A unique function here gets me the list of all the possible outcomes, and then I sorted that high to low. So we have 9520. Of course, then count if to figure out how many, to figure out the number of ties. I could have done a formula, but frankly, at this point, while the formula did look for a tie between 3 and 4, you also had to check to see if it was a tie between 2, the 3-way ties, or the 4-way tie here. And it was easier for me just to eyeball this and fill that in. And then here, 2-way tie, a sum if to count how many times that showed up. One thing that I do kind of like here, so these numbers divided by 1296 to get the percentages, but sometimes percentages is a hard thing to grasp, 14.8%. I love that Excel can take a percentage and convert it to a fraction. So equal 81.5%, let's copy that down. And if we ask to format those on the Home tab, number, fraction, up to one digit, it kind of rounds it to the nearest, like 4/5, that's close to 20%, 1/7, 14 point something percent, that's close enough. But then these here didn't work out as well as I would have liked, so I went back in to format cells and said up to two digits. So, you know, there was a chance, 1 in 54 chance, There would have been a three-way or four-way tie, which would have been just incredibly unsatisfying for those of us who grew up watching American college football and just hating when there's a tie game. Nothing good comes out of those tie games in American football. I get it. With the Premier League and soccer, football around the world, draws are important because you get that 1 point. So there you go. The Excel behind figuring out that we basically had almost a 20% chance that we were going to end up in a tie, and rather than advancing on the merits of the points, I had to go into these tiebreakers. All right, there you go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.